Hi, welcome back. I'm Frederick. These days, or rather weeks, I think all of us are reading a lot of articles about how to or how we should manage our companies in this situation, how we should stay resilient and we should show resolve and all the fantastic things that we should do. All the advisory firms, everybody is having an opinion on how we should be doing this. And of course, all the advice, they're good and right, and we should read them and we should consider and think about how do we do this. But this is the point. How do we do this? I read very little, if any, articles on how do we actually do this? How do we create a resilient company? How do we stay resilient as people? How do we show resolve? And this is where I think it gets a little difficult, right? Because how do we do that? I wrote a white paper about this. The point is that what I'm talking about in this white paper, it's all things that I've encountered, that I've done. It's things that I know are working. Of course, I haven't put them through a pandemic test yet, but my experience coupled with everything that I'm reading at the moment just shows me that this is the right way to go. It's quite simple, actually. It starts with you getting an understanding, an assessment of what is the new normal going to be? How will the world look? How will people react? How are companies facing the new normal when the pandemic is over? Or over enough for us to start getting out and starting looking at what's happening in the world? The new normal is the first thing you need to get used to. Building on the understanding of your new normal is a set of core guiding principles. These are principles like you need to run with the lowest possible fixed cost base. You need to have an agile organization to actually be flexible enough to respond to market changes. But because don't think that just because the pandemic is declared over, that the markets will stop changing. We will all have to find our new way of working, where to put our feet, so to speak, in the new normal, which means that we will see a lot of changes in the world. And we need to create a company strong enough to deal with that. We need to build an operating model that is permeating the whole company, an operating model that is something that we haven't seen before. It's an operating model that I've made work before, so it can be done. But the very fewest companies, they are capable of doing it today. A lot of changes have to happen. You have to create a true lean organization. You have to create a true virtual organization. You have to create a true agile organization. And these are a lot of changes that you have to do at the same time to get this to work. Based on your operating model, you have to look at your organizational structure. Because guess what? That has to change too. My claim is that if you look at the company that you're in today, if you want to have a strong place in the future, you have to do it with half the staff that you have today as permanent employees. And this is a key point. I'm not saying that you should let go of half of your people. I'm saying or suggesting that you should consider outsourcing half of your people. Why? Because it makes your fixed costs so much more flexible. So you would be able to, as a responsible company manager, to better withstand changes, fluctuations in the market going forward. That's what this white paper is about. There's a link right down here. I think you should go and read it. And I would love to hear your comments. Thank you for watching. Stay safe and good luck.